Hello everyone, it's Jen from Old Tinker Studio, and in today's GIMP tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to make a shiny gloss button. So let's create a new project, go to File, New, make the width 640 and the width height 400, click OK. Choose your rectangle tool, and under your options, you want to select rounded corners and make your radius 20. And draw a rounded rectangle in the background from the top left to the lower right. Go to Select and Save to Channel. Click back on your Layers tab and make a new layer. Call this one black. Layer fill type should be transparency. Click OK. Make sure your foreground is black. If it isn't, you can click on this little black and white icon. Choose your Paint Bucket Fill tool and fill the selection with black. Add a new layer, name this layer Feather, layer fill type of transparency, click OK, and go to Select, Feather, and we're going to feather this by 200 pixels, and click OK. Change your foreground color to a red. I'm going to use 9B 0000. Choose your bucket fill tool and go ahead and fill the selection in with red. Open your channels dialog box and make the selection mask copy active. Then choose the replace the selection with this channel, which is this red square. Go back to your Layers tab and make sure your feather layer is active. Go to Select, Invert, and hit Delete on the keyboard, and that overflow red in the corners will be deleted. Then go to Select, Invert. Now choose your Ellipse tool. And you want to drag an ellipse about halfway down the button, but make sure that you start outside of the background layer. Then go to Select and Shrink. You want to shrink this by 3 pixels. Click OK. Now choose your blend tool, or your gradient tool, as it's also known. Make sure your foreground color is white. You can do this by clicking on this little curved double-headed arrow. You want to change the option to foreground to transparent. Make sure your shape is linear. Add a new layer. Call this one gradient. And your layer fill type is transparency, and click OK. And using your control key to make sure it's straight, you want to start the stroke just above the selection and end it just below the selection. Then go to Select and None. Choose your text tool. And you want to type out your text. I'm going to be just using the sans font with a size of 175 and a color of black. Just click on your background and type out your text. Choose your alignment tool. Click on your text once. And then just choose align center of target and align middle of target. Choose your gradient layer and using the green arrow, move it to the top of the stack. And that's how you make a simple glossy button. And note, if you want the transparent background of these corners to make sure that it's rounded, you need to export the file as a PNG. I hope you found this useful. Have a good day.